I'm Katie, one of the optomechanical engineers here at Edmund Optics. Today, I'm going to talk about the different types of beam splitters we offer and provide you with information that will help you choose what beam splitter would work best for your application. Beam splitters are optical components that split light in two directions. For example, they are typically used in interferometers in order for a single beam to interfere with itself. In this setup, you can see laser light passing through a cube beam splitter. Some of the light continues in the direction of the laser, and some of the light is reflected at 90 degrees. We offer several different types of beam splitters: plate, cube, pellicle, and polka-dot beam splitters. A plate beam splitter is a common type of beam splitter that is composed of a thin glass substrate with an optical coating optimized for a 45-degree angle of incidence. Advantages of a plate beam splitter include less chromatic aberration, less absorption due to less glass, and smaller and lighter design compared to a cube beam splitter. Disadvantages of the plate beam splitter are the ghost images produced by having light reflect off both surfaces of the glass, lateral displacement of the beam due to the thickness of the glass, difficulty to mount without deformation, and their sensitivity to polarized light, which I'll discuss later. Cube beam splitters are essentially composed of two right-angle prisms cemented together at the hypotenuse, with a partially reflective coating in between. Advantages of the cube include easy mounting, durability of the optical coating since it is between the surfaces, and no ghost images since reflections propagate back in the direction of the source. Disadvantages of a cube are that it is bulkier and heavier than other types of beam splitters and doesn't cover as wide a wavelength range as pellicle or polka dot beam splitters, though we do offer many different coating options. Also, cube beam splitters should only be used with collimated beams, since converging and diverging beams contribute to considerable image quality degradation. Pellicle beam splitters are very thin, optical-grade film stretched over an aluminum ring and bound in place. They are useful because they have a broad wavelength range of operation, and therefore no chromatic aberration. They have no ghost image because the front and back surfaces have negligible thickness. They are very lightweight and take up little space in optical systems. The disadvantages of a pellicle beam splitter are that they are very delicate and easily punctured. Touching the surface will likely ruin the beam splitter, and great care must be taken when mounting a pellicle to reduce stress and vibration, as these can adversely affect performance. Pellicles are most useful for interferometric applications, but can prove to be too costly and delicate for common applications. Polka dot beam splitters do not split light as typical beam splitters. Rather, they have a polka dot surface in which the dots are reflective material that cover half the surface, with the other half being transparent. This splits the light much like a conventional beam splitter does, but has a completely reflective pattern coating rather than a partially reflective continuous coating as seen in conventional beam splitters. Advantages of polka dot beam splitters are that they have a broad wavelength range and their performance is not angle dependent. A disadvantage of polka dot beam splitters is their lower efficiency, usually around 85%, meaning that about 15% of the light is lost through the system. You may notice that some of our beam splitters are labeled as polarizing or non-polarizing. Polarizing beam splitters will reflect S-polarized light and transmit P-polarized light. With non-polarizing beam splitters, given randomly polarized input light, there will still be some polarization effects, but they depend on the specific type of beam splitter. For the Edmund Optics tech spec non-polarizing cube beam splitters, for example, the difference in reflection and transmission for S and P pole is less than 6%. If polarization states are not critical for your application, we recommend using non-polarizing beam splitters. I hope this answers your questions about different types of beam splitters we offer and which suit your needs. You can browse more of our technical application notes and videos to learn more key concepts and find answers to common questions on our website,